kill potential, so like something like a greedy slug would not really be that bad an idea. The damage off, now the Shadow Shaman is smoked up, moving into the mid lane. They have the Earth from here as well. Looks like Mocha is a little bit in trouble. He goes straight away to the Avenue Detection. They do have the Dust to be able to come back. But that is not going to be happening as he ends up dropping down. So very nice reaction from the Invoker, just, you know, in the middle of it, everything. He was like, okay, the owner just get the hell out, go invisible, and then try for the best. That is not going to work out just yet. We do have yet another kill happening as the Nikki has on every single time. Get a kill is always worth it. Top lane, lead in the meantime. It's open against top 10. Tencent isn't trying to get him away from all the hands. Black Shots go on. Vito taking a lot of damage here. And let's see, does pop this apothic to survive for a moment longer? And let's see the slot. He's trying to pop. He will get the pop on Tencent in the meantime. Nikki has goes invisible. Will that just trying to set up for the kill on Tencent? They will get the kill with some pressure dropping. Now Roger comes into the side. The latest strong from going to the floor. They want to try and go for a kill on the Slug. The Slug is trying to hide himself in the jungle in a moment. And LC is going to be regening up a little bit. He needs to get himself a lot of there though. 5 seconds to go. It's a little bit difficult to go for the Luna though, even though he has a main. He might be a little bit difficult for the go for. They set up. He will be killed if the Abaddon will pop this ultimate. He will go full HP with that meteor doing damage in the meantime in the backline. The Undersize comes out on the spot, so he will dodge it with his ultimate. Tenzin will be picked up in the meantime. Garchi, a little bit in trouble, not able to get himself out of that with the roll. He will be picked up with both Venus is out of defense. They will lose the fourth one as Venus is going to be the next one on the minion. No ult is available, and he drops down. If he ever win it, otherwise, he's going to lose it very soon. And honestly, he's going to lose it. Will be picked off straight away as well. That is all that is out of P-Town. The bottom center fracture is going to be taken down, and GG will play against all of TG. They just go all in and they go crazy. That Abaddon not really able to help anyone that fight us. No, sure, Abaddon can heal people up a little bit, but it does this much damage. The duel is made when the play build the sun strikes. It's just a little bit too much nuke for the Abaddon to deal with, even. Do you pick up Ursa here? Do you just go for the Ursa and then you let the Storm Spirit handle the Tink and then you just pick up a hero who's good against Abaddon and Lifesteal? Road available, and yeah, Hani's just moving himself around, trying to leech experience, not really getting any last. He is going to have to go for a skewer now. He might be a little bit in trouble, but looks like they don't want to go for a dive under the tower stretcher with the barbell coming up from the tanking. TP rotation, 10 minutes to another hit. That is going to be the first one. Fight in mid lane. Amel will be forced from the spot. They try to bring him alive. They try to keep him up and running. Oh, but he's going to be nuked down the sentence and will get the kill. The Argo will be taken down as well.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Bottom lane. Looks like the Argo might go. He's going to go for a spell field. The Argo is going to be running down the mid lane. Get as much damage out as possible. I'm not sure if the Argo will actually survive this. Looks like he's a little bit in trouble indeed. Vila will bring him down. On the other side of the map, they're trying to focus the life of the left mechanicals with that infest. So they go along and bring him down as TFD comes out. He's able as well, so they need to be very quick about jumping. Always going to be bringing it right into the claws of CG, as this is not going to be what you wanted this to be. Oh boy, that's not good. You know, flinging in, trying to get a little bit of march action going, trying to farm some of these jungle camps, but thing ends up being punished. Vila in the meantime is trying to run down the Storm Spirit. If you have that thing, everything available from the tank to go to the end of the game. It's going to be taken down very, very quickly. Meet that from now, he comes out on three people. Looks like it's going to be very difficult to pull off. As we is having a lot of heat cramps, the life will still alive for the moment. Fly solo, just have a soul from the field. The victory will pop it on himself. Will be alive for now. He's going to try and keep the life in control. Looks like he will be taken down after the false prompt ends. So, as Vito. Going to be chasing down all lightning jumps in the Storm Spirit. Just to check out what's happening. They do see the Roshan action. They do see the HP on the side. In the background, we see the solo coming in. We'll be able to fight up against the Magnus Wolf and another Magnus for the moment. Thank you. Talk about the Michael taking down the Jesse Yammer will be alive for the moment. Tank in the meantime. Get himself a little bit further away. We'll be imagining him for the moment. Looks like he's gonna be alive, Gabby. In the meantime. Trying to maybe cancel CPs or something like that, but did not happen. In the meantime, looks like they're gonna be the juggles. Maybe they're gonna stop the juggles. They try to bring him down, they will get the Aegis pop. Do they commit? Do they try to go for another jump? The Yavin is coming from it. The fight, the Yavin comes out. The life is going to be taken down. Was that Alpha Wolfing? The life still, that is his AC goal being used. Now he's going to be picked off the bottom of the seven. They get a jump on that Orkin. He's going to set up another kill on that life still. Seconds, no buyback available, and the one person that doesn't have buyback is the one person who's now dead inside of Beast Camp. In the meantime, buyback comes up from the Abaddon. Looks like CG. That could be the end. As Blue Fan, they lose 2 years straight off the bat. The Abaddon is going to pop his ultimate once again. The people will be back alive. Armel moving up towards the top area, so they're trying to force a fight on that. Invasion, they see him. He's going to force off himself away, but he will be pretty powerful. So that's a very nice reaction, but not good enough. The Shadow in the meantime from Magnus coming out. He does have his RP available, but I don't think he wants to try and go for a play on anyone here. We see the CM coming out. Okay, the RP comes out. Responds to the lifesteal as he's going to be all alone. They TP'd out Flasher, but there's just not enough arm to fight against this troll world. He's scary. Go up the high bump. Popping here comes out to the last one. He's going to go to the back. Target. The thing is going to go for the thing. The thing is going to take a lot of damage. He's going to pop out. GG well played. That's the end of the grand final, guys. As GG, they won't be able to take a 3-0, winning both of the games being played, plus having that upper bracket one game advantage. So CG still undefeated for a very, very long time, Geek Fam.